Good morning, this is Stephen Whiteside with your Daily Market Outlook for Tuesday, May 6, 2008. I'm running a little late this morning and I'd like to apologize. This is allergy season. I'm having a hard time the last couple of days, and hopefully we'll get the medications right and I'll be back to my normal self in the next couple of days. Now this morning in the pre-market, we're down across the board, so we are looking for some selling at the open on Tuesday morning. Now yesterday at this time, we were looking at the 60-minute charts for the major indexes. We noted that even though the TSX was projecting higher, that it was probably going to have some trouble at previous resistance. And that previous resistance came in at 14,375, which is also daily and weekly resistance. So even though we had a strong opening yesterday, we ran up to that resistance point and then the market sold off going into the close yesterday. That selling that we saw in the afternoon was not enough to give us a new sell signal. We would need to see an hourly close below 14,250. Now, looking at the U.S. markets, we noted yesterday that the 60-minute panic zone charts looked like they were starting to roll over, and we did see some weakness on Monday, and we are on a sell signal. That sell signal would be reconfirmed on the S&P 500 with an hourly close below 14.05, and we should see that Tuesday morning at the open. Looking at the NASDAQ, similar situation. We've got that early warning signal up there at the top of the chart. The chart's starting to turn red. We saw some selling yesterday, which did give us a sell signal on the NASDAQ. If the market wants to move higher on Tuesday, then I'd like to see a close above 2472 before I would abandon the short-term intraday sell signal. Now, another way to look at the market is to look at the VIX index and see what people are willing to pay for their options. If they start to get scared, then they'll need to pay more money to buy options to protect their portfolios. So if the VIX index is able to move up above 1950 on an hourly basis, that's another way to confirm that the market actually wants to go lower right now. Yesterday was a big day for the energy sector, and that helped prop up the TSX. We had crude oil up over 3.5%. We had natural gas up over 3.5%. I think those are both one-day events, and I don't think we're going to see the energy sector start to run away here. I think that those are probably just extremes. It was Monday morning. People came in. There was a lot of news on the table, and we had a lot of buying in crude oil. I don't think you're going to see follow through to the upside for those particular commodities going forward. Unfortunately, that's going to give us a sell signal on our Horizon Beta Pro Bear Energy ETF. And I'm not going to reverse and go long the Canadian energy sector, even though I have a sell signal on the short position. The charts look very similar to the TSX themselves, where they were up at the top of the panic zones. So any buying opportunity here on the long side is certainly not a low-risk buying opportunity. And looking at the U.S. side, the ultra shorts for the oil and gas sector, we're on the cusp of getting a sell signal. If energy stocks in the U.S. move higher on Tuesday, then we would get a sell signal at the close of trading on Tuesday afternoon. Now, as I mentioned, we do have buy signals on the bullish energy ETFs, the Horizon Beta Pro bull ETF for the Canadian market. We don't have one for the U.S. market, so I'm not going to just roll over and go long the Canadian energy sector. I don't think this is a low-risk opportunity, so I'm going to stand aside. I have enough other things on my plate right now that I don't need to chase this particular trade. And again, on the U.S. side, we do not have a buy signal on the ultra longs for the U.S. oil and gas sector. Now, gold was up sharply yesterday, and unfortunately, that put pressure on our short Horizon Beta Pro Bear ETF. And we would, if the Canadian gold sector continued higher on Tuesday, I'm sure that we would get a sell signal at the close of day, close of trading on Tuesday on this particular ETF. Now, looking at the U.S. side of the border, our ultra shorts for the U.S. basic material sector, that gave us a sell signal yesterday, so we're going to take our loss, stand aside, and not worry about the long equivalent for that particular ETF. Now, I'm going to look at the top 10 stocks on the TSX and just walk through them, show you where they are. A lot of them are gold stocks at the present time, and most of those are getting ready to issue a buy signal. And if I was following any of these stocks, I would certainly take the buy signals. Barrick Gold is down at the bottom of the panic zone. We've got a nice big pressure zone forming there, and we did have that a big up day yesterday, but not enough to give us a buy signal. We still need a daily close above $41 to give us a buy signal for this particular stock. Looking at Bombardier, the next stock, it's up at the top of the panic zone, so we're looking for an exit strategy right now, and we would get that on a daily close below 645. That would give us a sell signal on Bombardier, and we're not there right now. BCE is our next stock this morning. You'll notice it's in the middle of the panic zone, so we're coming off that early warning signal at the top of the screen. We're a few weeks back, we had a pressure zone form, so I call it no man's land. There's really nothing to do here. If you don't own the stock, there's nothing to do at the moment. If you wanted to buy this stock, your next buying opportunity would come on a daily close above 37.43, not something that I'd be interested in taking. Now, Eastern Platinum is down at the bottom of the panic zones. We've got a pressure zone forming, and we would buy this stock. If you were following this stock, you'd want to buy it on a daily close above $2.98. Looking at Equinox Minerals, we're down near the bottom of the panic zones. We didn't get the severe sell-off that we've seen in other stocks. It's been trading sideways for the last couple of weeks. We've got a pressure zone at the bottom of the screen, and we're on the cusp of a new buy signal. If it moves higher on Tuesday, that would confirm the buy signal for this particular stock. Looking at Goldcorp, we're down at the bottom of the panic zones, pressure zone at the bottom of the screen. We would get a new buy signal for this stock on a daily close above 38.20. Looking at Great West Life, we have a huge pressure zone down here. Through all that financial crisis, a lot of the financial stocks sold off dramatically and had very large pressure zones forming. This would be considered a normal pressure zone, and as you can see, the stock moved up nicely, and that's when the financial crisis started to hit in December last year. So when we were down at the bottom of the panic zones here, we had this pressure zone form. You can see the oscillators went off, stock started to move up, started to have blue bars. That was your low risk buying opportunity. Now, we have not seen it come up high enough to penetrate the top of the panic zones at all. We do have an early warning signal up here, so we are looking for an exit strategy. And yesterday we landed with a sell signal at the close of trading on Monday for Great West Life. Now, our next stock this morning is High River Gold. Again, we've got a huge pressure zone at the bottom of the screen. We're at the bottom of the panic zones, and yesterday we closed above the upper channel line, so that is a buy signal for that particular stock. IM Gold is the next stock up this morning. Again, we're at the bottom of the panic zones. We've got a pressure zone forming, and this stock would issue a buy signal with a daily close above 640 on Tuesday. Looking at Kinross Gold, I believe this is our last stock of the day this morning, another gold stock, and we're at the bottom of the panic zones with a pressure zone forming, and this stock would issue a buy signal on a daily close above 2090. Okay, that's all for Tuesday morning, folks. On Wednesday morning, we'll take a look at the most active stocks on the NYSE. Have a great day, and we'll talk to you again on Wednesday morning.